Persistent Air Leak, Review of Literature, Thoracic Masterclass. Definition: It is a leak that persists for greater than 5 to 7 days, causes, either due to alveolar pleural or bronchopleural fistula. By far, postoperative persistent air leak are the most common, but they may also occur after spontaneous pneumothorax due to underlying lung disease.
Overview: But persistent air leak is a cause of significant morbidity in patients after lung surgery, and those with parenchymal lung disease suffering from a pneumothorax. Although conservative treatment with chest drain and observation is usually effective, other invasive techniques are needed when conservative treatment fails. Surgical management and medical pleurodesis have longer been the usual treatments for persistent leak. Bronchoscopic procedure, however, have been introduced to treat leaks in those patients who are poor candidates for surgery or who declined surgery. These techniques include bronchoscope accused of sealants, sclerosants, various types of implanted devices.
This factors for development of persistent early. There are general factors and local factors related to the procedures. General factors include low forced expiratory volume in the first second, female gender, smoking, diabetes mellitus, and the use of corticosteroids. After lung volume reduction surgery and pulmonary resections, leaks increase with patients who have low carbon monoxide effusion, intraoperative adhesions, incomplete fissure, and upper lobe emphysema. Factors that may increase leaks after video-assisted thoracoscopic treatment of spontaneous pneumothorax may include underlying lung disease, old age, large bully.
Quantification of air leak. Sifolio classified air leak into 4 grades according to its relation to the respiratory cycle. Grade 1: this leaks during forced exhalation, cough. Grade 2: leaks during expiration only. Grade 3: leaks during inspiration only. Grade 4: leaks continuous throughout the respiratory cycle. It is of note that grade 3 and 4 denotes a bronchopleural fistula. Further, McIerney classified grade 1 into 4 categories: grade 0, note leak; grade 1, countable bubbles; grade 2, streams of bubbles; grade 3, coalesced bubbles. Summary of possible management include conservative, non-surgical, surgical, bronchoscopic.
The overall goal is to maintain adequate ventilation and oxygenation, to resolve the air leak allowing for full lung expansion, if possible, to decrease length of hospital stay, and to prevent recurrence of the air leak. In this lecture we will discuss management related to a leak without bronchopleural fistula. Conservative management, chest tube, and observation is the initial step. However, 3 valuations should be considered in all patients: air leak volume, which calls for grading and quantification; air leak duration; air leak trend, which denotes whether the leak is continuous, intermittent, or decreasing in day-to-day assessments.
Conservative management in patients without bronchopleural fistula: water seal versus suction. There is not a current consensus on whether or not placing the chest tube to suction delays the time needed for the fistulous tract to heal. Some authors contend that water seal rather than active suction promotes healing of the alveolar pleural fistula in pneumothorax by decreasing flow of air through the defect, and thereby improving apposition of the lung tissue. Others believe that applying suction removed air from the pleural space at the rate greater than that of air leakage, via the visceral pleural defect, promoting apposition between the visceral and parietal pleura, thus enhancing healing. Conservative management in patients without bronchopleural fistula: the use of one-way Heimlich valve, if the air leak but exists, but it is not large enough to require suction to keep the lung expanded, then I would patient management with a one-way flutter valve can be effective. However, this approach has its drawbacks, which may include discomfort with prolonged chest drain, increased risk of pleural infection, malfunction, or malposition of the valve leading to the accumulation of pneumothorax with or without tension, patient dissatisfaction with fluid leakage from the drainage system. It is of note that these patients should be seen regularly on outpatient basis to follow them up closely.
Conservative management of patient with a leak and on mechanical ventilation, positive pressure ventilation, worsen air leaks, and impaired healing, the best strategy is to try spontaneous breathing and early extubation, if possible. Meanwhile, reduce tidal volume, expiratory pressure, and inspiratory time, if air leak interferes with patient ventilation, or increasing surgical emphysema, try placing another chest tube, apply negative suction, surgical intervention in hopefully weanable patients. Digital chest draining system, the ability of such systems to not only measure the rate of air leak, but monitor its change over time may allow physicians to predict which air leaks are likely to resolve without intervention, and which ones are normally likely to benefit most from early active management.
Non-surgical management, chemical versus autologous blood pleurodesis. Only if the lung is fully expanded, pleurodesis can be done. Chemical pleurodesis is recommended by existing guidelines for spontaneous pneumothorax for the recurrence prevention in those patients with persistent air leak who are not candidate for surgery. Although the evidence of its effectiveness is mixed, the most commonly used sclerosing agent for this indication are tetracycline derivatives and talc. Autologous blood is a technique in which the patient's own venous blood is instilled into the pleural space with its coagulates, sealing the site of the air leak. The volume of blood to be installed varies in different reports from 50 milliliters to 200 milliliters per installation. Report showed that success rate may be up to 85%.
Surgical management, it is the mainstay of therapy in those patients in whom our leaks do not resolve using conservative means. Post-operative air leaks, drainage of an empire email with the reinforcement of the stump or any of the section are typical. The report that rate of successful surgical treatment of post-operative leak is between 80-95%. Air leak secondary to spontaneous pneumothorax, surgical management includes a section of any blebs, bully, all the visible abnormalities of the visceral pleura, as well as mechanical and or chemical pleurodesis, to achieve pleural symphysis. In unfit patients, non-surgical or bronchoscopic management is attempted. Bronchoscopic management of air leak, the first step and probably the most crucial one, remains the accurate localization of the air leak. This can be achieved by selective balloon bronchial inclusion and watching the air leak, installation of methylene blue via the chest tube and watching the segments through the bronchoscope, oxygen insufflation at 2-4 L via the bronchoscope, and watching air leak. A number of compounds have been instilled bronchoscopically to attempt to close off the site of persistent leaks. Among the sealants reported are fibrin, fibrin glue, cyanoacrylate glue, oxidized cellulose, albumin glutaraldehyde glue, hydrogel. Reported sclerosants include ethanolamine, ethanol, and tetracycline. Bronchoscopy placed one-way valves, two valves in the market, Zephyr, and Spiration. They can be placed via bronchoscope, and they moved 6 weeks later. There are four sizes available to accommodate bronchial diameter between 5 and 9 mm. There are small series published, with the success rate up to 55% reported.